Hey, hello, hi, it's me, Zach, a YouTube local trans boy. And so I'm 2 weeks post-op now. It's April the 4th of 2017, just for reference. And so I've just taken my first shower since having the operation. So I feel quite a bit cleaner, not entirely, because you can't have a proper shower. It's just a case of just having water trickling down you. Nothing powerful, nothing too warm, but I got to wash my hair in the shower, so yay for clean hair, like properly clean hair and face and shoulders and everywhere, you know. So just for your information, when you do have a shower post-op, the nurse told me that what's best to do is when you wash your hair, just to let the soap suds, the bubbles, whatever you want to call it, once you've lathered it up, just when you wash it out, just let the soap, the shampoo, just trickle down you, not actually scrubbing or washing your chest. So anyway, I'm going to be showing you what it looks like right now that I've come out of the shower, and what it looks like underneath the dressings, and I'm also going to show you how to redo it, possibly, or at least I'll film myself taking it off and possibly putting it back on, to see how easy it is to film us doing that. So, okay, let's show you what it looks like right now. So I showered with all of this on, so it's kind of wet, as you can see. So this is the plaster with, you can vaguely see the outline of my nipple underneath. Hashtag censored. Anyway, this lump here, yesterday I looked at it in the morning and it was a lot smaller than that, but by the evening it had come up again, but regardless, it's a lot less swollen and inflamed as it was right after surgery. Also, 2 weeks post-op, my left nipple area, chest side, whatever you want to describe that region as, it was very swollen and it kind of looks like I had like moobs and, you know, it was swollen, so just it had more substance to it. It wasn't that flat. Today, I'm pretty flat, and I put a t-shirt on this morning when I woke up. And first of all, I put the t-shirt on by myself. It was the first time I put a t-shirt on since having surgery, and it was a really cool feeling. I was excited. I was just like, wow. And I looked at myself in the mirror and I thought, you know what, I'm flat. You know, I had all of this on, the dressings on, but it was a good feeling. I don't want to rub that in your face if you are still pre-op, or you don't want surgery in your binding. I don't want to rub that in your face, but just for my own memory, that feeling, yeah. Okay. So on that note, I'll also look forward to when I put a t-shirt on for the first time without all this plasters and the Steri-Strips, even though that's probably going to be a while. I'm also a bit nervous about that because the sensation, if I have sensation in my nipples, I feel that's going to be a bit weird. So I don't know what this face is doing today, but anyway, I don't know if it's excited or nervous. So anyway, back on to my chest. So as you can see, we've got this, as I described. Still a bit of bruising, but a lot less than I had. You can see the Steri-Strips going across here, well, that's where my incision are. Again, this is still that Sharpie marker pen line. And the other incision on this side, you can see the where the drain was, and the vertical incision, and you can't really see my nipple outline on this, so maybe you can. Anyway, so we're going to walk us over to where I'm going to take the dressings off. I'm just going to place you down here. I don't know how this is going to work, or if this is going to work very well, but we'll give it a go. So, apologies, you're going to hear the tap running now, because it's important to keep clean and hygienic, however you say it. So I'm just going to wash my hands with this antimicrobial hand and body wash. It's chlorhexidine gluconate, 4%. It's a pinky reddy colour, so I'm going to wash my hands, so apologies for the tap. Oh, you can see bubbles. That's fun. I'm not a child. Of course not. Right, so now that I've washed my hands, dry them off. I should also say that when I got out of the shower, I had two towels. One for the rest of my body and my hair, and one towel that was just for my chest. And it's important to keep them separate. Don't use a new towel, a fluffy towel, you don't want the fluff on you. So let's just show you what I have here. So, these, and obviously not sponsored, obviously, because YouTube, but they'll think it's sponsored. But anyway, we've got these adhesive surgical dressings, okay? Latex-free, water-repellent and breathable. They're sterile, and that's the important thing, is they're sterile. So I'll quickly show you that. That's what these are. So, two of those. Then also, again, not sponsored. You know, I have a personal gripe with YouTube today and the last few weeks because of what they've done with their restrictions. That's a whole other video. But anyway, so these Steri-Strips, you can see that. Again, latex-free. And it says Steri-Strips, reinforced skin closure. I mean, you can get these in your pharmacy. And gauze, again, sterile. Everything is sterile. I have these tweezers, so we're just gonna run them under really hot water. I mean, they're not dirty, but just for peace of mind. And so I'm gonna remove these Steri-Strips on this side. I'm removing them because they are very wet, and the left side, as I mentioned in my previous video, the nurse wasn't going to put Steri-Strips on, but I do feel just, you know, a bit happier with them on. It helps me feel that I'm not gonna do any damage, and they do have this healing property about them. Don't know how else to describe it. You can just listen to my rambles as I do this. You know, this video is definitely gonna take this off now. It's easier because it is wet. So this is my nipple. And it's odd to be showing you my nipple, because 2 weeks ago, if I'd done this, well, let's just say social media would have not accepted this video at all. It would have been removed. It is interesting. When do you consider a chest to be suitable for showing on the internet and visible? I'm kind of rambling as I do this. I hope you don't mind. Again, I should have probably said at the start that this would be a bit gory. Sorry, I'm just using the smaller mirror to guide me on this side because I can't really see it very well. Because all I see is the swollen bump. So, I mean, talking about my nipples again, you can see what the nurse meant by they're quite dark. Part of that is the purple pen that the surgeon used. And part of it is because it's scabbing over, I believe. This also doesn't hurt, by the way. It can get quite itchy. The incisions can be kind of itchy. Also a mixture of the adhesive, because I'm kind of sensitive. I'm going to take this side off as well. I wasn't going to, but because it's so wet, that's the only reason that I'm taking it off. Otherwise, I might have left it until tomorrow. But I was desperate for the shower, which the nurse said I could finally have. You definitely can't see on this camera, but I have quite a bit of hair, which they shaved off before they operated. But they waited until I was under anesthesia to shave me. Probably so I didn't freak out. They are good. They understand dysphoria and they understand how uncomfortable some trans people are with their bodies. They understand that and are respecting of that. So whenever they were going to do something... Oh, sorry, this is proving a bit of a problem here. Whenever they were going to do something, they'd always ask me first if it was okay. And they also appreciated when they had to do something, like the drawing on me whilst I was still awake. They didn't make a big deal of it. They just got on with it. I will make a whole video, if you want, on my experience at the hospital as a whole, from the consulting side of things before I... Now this as well, you're seeing this for the first time, but I'm also seeing this for the first time. I've not seen this yet, properly anyway, because like I said, when I got it changed the very first time, I didn't look properly because I was kind of nervous and I didn't want to freak myself out. I'm also not very good with blood. And I didn't really want to see something that was so raw. I didn't want to make myself uncomfortable and unhappy with it. So now, seeing at this stage, it's much better, I think. And it will give me an indication on how I will possibly start healing over time. What my scars may look like in the future. It's quite nice to have all of this off as well. It's been 2 weeks of having plasters on and sticky stuff and stuff holding me together and all that. So this, I'm sorry, I'm on my tiptoes, I'm a bit shaky. This is what it looks like 2 weeks. So bruising here, I think that will go down. This lump is very noticeable and a bit of a lump here, but I imagine it will go down My only concern is this is very hard. This here is solid. And it wasn't that solid before. So it's a bit of a worry. But yeah. I have some of that sutures in this bit here still. And again, we've got this area here, which I talked about in my vlog whilst I was out on my walk, that is making me feel a bit unhappy. But, you know, it is what it is. And at the end of the day, I'm just thankful that I don't have to bind anymore. And I think with time, I'll grow to learn. With time, I will learn and grow to be happy with what I have now. So, on to the next stage. I think I will just wash my hands again. Again, I'm apologising for this video in the bathroom. Should just have a series of bathroom videos, shouldn't I? You can see it's very red and a bit bumpy where the plasters were. That's just sensitive skin for you. So this is the plasters I showed you, the size they are. I'm just going to open the packets up so it makes it easier when I come to putting them on. And I didn't show you this before. This is the eye ointment. You can see it. I try and read it for you, but let's give it a go. My name's not on there. No, it's not going to happen. But it's eye ointment. It says apply twice a day to the affected area as directed. 28 days after opening. So it's 1% and it comes in a 4 mg tube. If you're at a different place, they might give you something else. Again, none of this is sponsored. None of this is product promotion. This is just because it's an educational video, YouTube. I'm still not quite over this YouTube censoring business, as we can see. So this is the tube it comes in, and I have one tube for each nipple. So this is the left side. So what we do is we get our gauze, and I need to open a fresh packet because you get 5 sheets in each packet, and you use 1 gauze per nipple. This helps with cross-contamination, and so if you were to get infected on one side, you're not going to get infected on the other side as well. Keeps it localized. So what we're gonna do is we get this and we put it onto the gauze, like a pea-sized amount, and we make sure that we put the cap back on and we put it back into the right box, because the box is labelled, the tube isn't, so it's going on the left, and my dyslexic brain needs to remember which side is my left side, which is this side. So what we do is we get the gauze and we put it on the nipple, all on there. And she gave me this analogy that you do it like a clock face, so you put it all on and then you go out to the numbers. So 12, 6, 9, and 3, and all around there. It might look sore and painful, but it's not. It is a slight concern that I'm not feeling as much. compared to last week. I don't know whether that's a good sign or a bad sign. Might be a bad sign, because, like I mentioned in my last video, feeling probably indicates being alive. Yes, the human aspect of being alive, feeling. No, but I mean that if I can feel it and I have sensation, it means the nerves are still alive. So what I'm doing is I'm folding the edges of the plaster. You can't really see it, but there you go, you fold it in so that it gives it space to breathe, and I don't have the adhesive sticking on the scarring, well, the incision, because I don't know when does it change from being an incision to a scar. Not too sure. Interesting ramble there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to stick it on here. With the fold that I made going along here. And I fold it in on itself so it's on the sticky part. And again, on here. Now, the reason we have this gap at the top so it breathes. Even though the plaster's Band-Aids, if you're American. Even though Band-Aid's a brand, right? I don't know. So, we're going to do the same on the other side. Sorry about my rubbish from the plasters here. Do the same the other side. So we get the gauze. Now, it's obviously, like I mentioned, hygiene and keeping clean and sterile is really important. Again, so we've got the same stuff, but it says right, for the right nipple. What was I gonna say? It's, yeah, important to keep clean and hygienic, so, I mean, I wash my hands with that, that special scrub, so my hands are nice and clean, but some people might feel much better and also more hygienic to wear latex gloves. Latex? Or do I just mean rubber gloves? You know those disposable gloves you get that doctors and nurses wear? Wearing that whilst you do this, if you aren't using gauze to put it on. Because this is sterile, so and I'm not touching it with my hands. And it goes onto the nipple again. And that round the clock. And out to the numbers. Just, you know, ensuring that it's covered and nice and clean. This video is horrendously long, but I really do hope that it is helpful to somebody who hasn't had all of this information that I am really lucky to have, and I'm going to make a whole video on this, I imagine, but living fairly close to the hospital that I had this procedure done at has meant that I can go back with ease. So I'm going this week again. Whereas if I had gone somewhere not very easy to get to from where I live, I wouldn't be able to go back and receive this help and advice. And just peace of mind, I guess. So that's the nipples recovered. And the next thing we're going to do is the Steri-Strips, but you've seen what the Steri-Strips look like. So I think I'll leave this video here and I'll do the Steri-Strips myself off camera. So This is the scarring, what it looks like. 2 weeks post-op, I'm going to wash my hands again and reapply the Steri-Strips and just cool off and dry off. So thanks very much for watching. I really hope this helps you. Or even if it doesn't help you and you're just curious, because I know some people will just be curious, especially if they know me. they want to see what I've been through maybe, or if you're trans and you're interested in this surgery with these surgeons or similar procedure elsewhere. Hope it helps, and I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.